Satish. And I'm Jack.
Hello friends. Today we will study how to use a burette in a proper way. This part is the tip of the burette. This is the stopcock which will help you to control the flow. There's a zero mark at the top of the burette and a 50 ml mark at the bottom. The burette is to be read from top to bottom. The initial step is to clean and rinse the burette. The cleaning part is to be done with water. You put the water from the top of the burette and tilt it and turn it in this way. Then open the knob and empty it. Now you need to close the knob. The next step is to put some amount of the titrant into the burette and repeat the same steps. Then mount the burette on the clamp. The next step is to fill the burette with a titrant, and I recommend not to use a funnel for the same. The reason being, after using the funnel, you might keep it down and allow foreign particles to enter your solution in the next filling. This part of the burette has air gap and we need to remove it. So release the solution in full flow and the air gap will be removed. Once the air gap is removed, fill the solution in the burette above the zero mark. For colorless solution, we need to see the lower meniscus, and for colored solution, we need to see the upper meniscus. You can arrange the burette according to your height by unscrewing and moving it in this way. Open the knob of the burette and adjust the lower meniscus to the zero mark. It is necessary that the meniscus is to your eye level to avoid the parallax error. Once the meniscus is adjusted, unscrew it and do it this way. After you are done with your experiment, you need to look at the meniscus again at the eye level to avoid the parallax error. Remember, the burette reading has to be reported in two decimal places. In this particular burette reading, some students might write 32.6 and some might write 33.4. Which of these readings are right? Please comment in the comment box below. Please do like,
share,
and comment.